Hello guys, how is everyone doing today? I hope everyone is doing good. I am doing good. Just got through taking the kids to school. And it's time to give the Lord some praise. So if you haven't already, let's give him some praise for letting us see this day that was not promised to you or I. And for that, we need to tell him thank you. So thank you, Lord, for allowing me to see this day, because somebody somewhere did not wake up this morning, but Lord, you allowed us to, and we just want to say thank you. So thank you, Lord. So we're back at it. We're on 40 days of biblical declarations. If you haven't been following me in this series, go back and watch some of my other videos. I'm going to link them right up there. And I'm sure that it will bless your soul, because this is declaring to the Lord things that will change our lives. And as we start off every day with Psalms 118 and 24, and it says, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Yes, we have to be glad, because it's a blessing to see this day, because somebody laid down last night and did not wake up this morning. So rejoice, because he let you open your eyes to see this day. So let's rejoice in the Lord today. Okay, number two is Psalms 24:9. It says, "Today I will keep my head lifted up and allow the King of the glory to infiltrate every area of my life." So today, keep your head lifted up. No matter what you're going through, just let the Lord work through you today. Let him bring in that positive power. And don't worry about what you're going through. Pray to the Lord. Give it to him and let him have it. And let your day be wonderful. Ecclesiastes 1:13 says, "Today I will seek and search out wisdom with my heart, and I believe that God will reveal his will to me." So if we seek out wisdom and we ask the Lord to reveal those things that he has for us today, we need to do that. So we can grow closer and we can see what path the Lord has for us. And wisdom, you know, get more insight on the things that he has planned for our life. So today, let's claim that, guys. Let's declare that. Isaiah 4:29 say, "I decree that the power and the strength of God will sustain me today when I want to faint and when I have no might." Like when you want to give up, just know that the will of the Lord is going to keep you. Like when you want to give up, you want to faint, and you say, "Everything is not going my way." Just remember, decree today that the Lord will keep you, and then again, those positive vibes. Don't let the devil tell you that that all those negative things is going to happen, because you're going to decree it in the word of the Lord that God would keep you in those faint places and on the places that you don't even know which way to turn, that God is going to be right there to pick you up. Colossians 1:13 say, "I decree that I have been delivered from power of darkness and translated into the kingdom of God." Yes, we will have you have to decree this thing that no darkness, that means no problems. We ain't gonna worry about the problems. We ain't gonna worry about the bills. We're not gonna worry about the sickness, because as it said in the verse before, the Lord will sustain us. And in this verse, it tells us that the Lord is gonna deliver us from those dark places, that he is gonna help us along the way. So we must believe and have faith that the Lord is gonna do that today. So just decree that you, those dark places and those faint places and the things that's trying to tear you down, we're not going to have it today. We're going to decree and declare that the will of God is going to keep us today. James 2:5 say, "I decree that I love God. I am a hearer to his, I am an heir to his kingdom. So today I embrace my inheritance." Yeah, so today, everything that the Lord has promised us in his word, that he's telling us today, that to decree that we're going to claim our inheritance. Everything that he has for us today, we're going to decree that we are going to inherit that thing, and we're going to just embrace that. that everything that he has for us today, we're going to stand on our inheritance. So, yes, guys. So, all of this thing so far is telling us that no matter what, those dark places, those things that's tearing us down, all of those things, we're going to keep that out of our midst today. We're going to think positive, and we're going to inherit the things that he has for us today. So, no matter what, if you feel like you in one of those negative places, just say a little prayer. Have faith that the Lord is going to sustain you, that he is going to keep you, that he is going to be right there with you. And we're not going to have no negative in our life today. We're going to claim our inheritance, and we're just going to have a great day today. So all these things are really good so far, I think. So let's keep right on going. So Romans 4 and 18 and 19, it says, in this new season, I will hope against hope and will be strong in my faith, knowing that every promise God has made to me will come to pass no matter what. Yes, that is something right now to be shouting about, because everything that the Lord has promised to us, we're going to claim it today. Our inheritance, as it was saying in the verse before, we're going to claim that thing. And no matter what today brings at us, we're just going to be joyful. We're going to be positive, and we're going to just uplift the Lord. We're going to not let anything get to us. Today, we're going to do that, guys. So when that old devil come and try to throw that little monkey wrench in the system, we're going to say, no, not today. Because the Lord has promised us all these good things. He said he's going to sustain us. He's going to be there right there with us. And then he says, believe and claim your inheritance. And then he says, we're going to claim that no matter what that old devil tried to throw at us, we ain't even having it today. Everything is positive today. Psalms 147 and 14 says, I decree that peace shall dwell with my borders today, and God will grant his very best to me. Yes, that is so amazing. That peace is going to be all around us, no matter what. It's going to be all around us. Our borders means that everything us and connects. It connects, and nothing is going to seep into our area today. We're going to be happy. We're going to claim our inheritance. We are going to depend on the Lord to sustain us in those places where we are not even feeling like it. But today, we're going to claim all those things. Our day is going to be positive today. And nothing that the devil tries to throw at us is going to be blocked. So no weapons formed against us today is going to prosper. That's the attitude that we're going to have today. No weapons formed shall prosper. We're not even going to let him in our midst. Everything about today is going to be positive. And when it try to get a little negative, we're just going to say a little prayer to the Lord, because he already told us in his word that he will never leave us nor forsake us. So when we get those little negative vibes, we're just going to say, Lord, help me. So, yes, so we're going to seal this deal today, and it comes from 1 Kings 8 and 56. It says, I decree that every promise that God has made to me through his word will flourish in my life and will never fail. And that's the deal breaker. Everything that he has promised us is going to be built up. You know, it's going to flourish today. And nothing is going to fail. That's the attitude that we're going to have today, guys. We're going to decree and declare this thing. And we're going to believe and have faith. And all the borders of us, we're going to they're going to be protected today. And we're just going to have a very positive day today. No negatives shall come to anyone that's watching this video. That is my prayer. And we're just going to uplift the name of the Lord. And we're just going to have a positive day. We're going to claim our inheritance. Everything that the Lord has promised us, we're going to claim it today. We're claiming victory, guys. So, yeah, that's it, guys. I thank you for taking time out your day to listen to little old me. I try to encourage everybody, because every once in a while, we all need a little encouragement, even me. So that's why I read this book and share with you guys, because not only am I encouraging you guys, I am encouraging myself and getting a little bit better in my walk with the Lord. So I thank you guys. I love you guys, and God loves you also, and be blessed, my people.